अंबिका सोनी टॉप लीडर ऑफ द कांग्रेस इज लाइकली टू कंटेस्ट फ्रॉम अनंतपुर साहिब।
Nandita now joins us for more on this story. Nandita, just take us through the details. What are you picking up as of now?
A big breaking news coming right now at 7 o'clock that Ambika Soni, who is a senior leader of the Congress party and somebody who has stayed away from elections, stayed away from Lok Sabha, but is a Rajya Sabha member. She served as the INB minister, senior cabinet minister in Dr. Manmohan Singh's cabinet. Of course, after that, she quit and said that she would like to work closely with Sonia Gandhi and is retiring from, you know, that hectic way of electoral politics. But now it seems the Congress has decided to put their best foot forward in each constituency. So within minutes of news breaking that Amarinder Singh is going to be contesting from Amritsar, we're also getting news that Ambika Soni, one of the Congress's senior most leaders, is going to be contesting from Anandpur Sahib. There is, of course, a big question mark before the final announcement comes, but we are hearing from credible sources that her name is in the running from Anandpur Sahib.
It's very interesting the kind of strategy that is being employed within the Congress, Nandita. A few senior leaders, ministers, in fact, stepping back from the poll fray, and others who had taken a step back from active politics, in fact, now deciding to contest the elections. What really is the game plan here?
That is right, but I think the larger strategy is get the old war horses into the elections. Of course, there is that one case of P. Chidambaram who's decided to stay away and give way to his son in Shivaganga. But apart from that, if you see whether it's Mani Shankar Iyer, Ghulam Nabi Azad, the likes of C.P. Joshi, who of course fought Lok Sabha earlier, but this time were unwilling to do so, I think I've got a strong message from Rahul Gandhi that this time round, because it's tough election, all the more reason for the big guns to come into the electoral fray. So the latest news, the latest name that we're breaking right now is Ambika Soni from Anandpur Sahib in Punjab. Interesting because the Punjab list, half of the names are yet to be announced, whether it's Manish Tiwari from Ludhiana or Captain Amrinder Singh from Amritsar. Now, it is starting to make sense why that announcement of the Punjab list has not happened because clearly names like Ambika Soni are expected to figure in that list as well.
You know, Nandita, point well taken that a stern message would have gone down that you can't just pontificate and do party politics and not really get into the hustle bustle of elections. But how much of this is actually going to work? Take us to the dynamics, because, you know, there is a backfiring chance also. You're paradropping leaders into places that they haven't visited in the last 5 years or have been actively involved. And then that outsider tag gets attached, that stigma. People are very, very concerned about that aspect as well. What is her equation then in Anandpur Sahib?
Well, she's been fairly active in Punjab politics, but of course, the fact that she's operated more from the capital, from Delhi, is something that could work against her. But she is a leader who hails originally from Punjab. So though she is somebody who's, you know, been like a major figure here in Delhi, dealing with different factions in Punjab politics, though she's not been, not been in charge, but nonetheless, known to be somebody who's fairly close to Captain Amrinder Singh, so knows the area well. But of course, the fact that she'd be fighting a contest, an election from there now is something new. And that's going to be a huge challenge, not just for her, but for others also. But the strategy seems to be to push the old senior lot into the electoral fray. That's the message that's really coming out from the kind of names that have been announced by the Congress party in the past few days.